Okay, this time I'm going to concentrate on the foreground. I've made a little start at one side. Because the sun is kind of hitting the cliff bank, it's sort of orangey colour right at the edge, I would imagine. Mixed up various yellows. We want some shadows in a moment. Quite bright yellow for there. And we don't want it too. Want it to look as if there's a hint of grass, leaves or whatever. And then for a little bit darker as it kind of rolls down the cliff. So a little bit there where I've got a little rolling bit. Maybe there. Just to kind of show that it goes up and down a little bit, just a few lighter bits and darker bits of what we're aiming for. So now I'll go back to the lighter parts, more yellow and a hint of white, maybe a bit too much white. Colour out there. Quite a lot of flowers there, and I'll probably make them a little bit bigger than they actually would be, just because we're not trying to be too realistic here. Keep it fun and modern style. Say to people in my art group, and get some who copy a photo religiously and say, oh, you've missed that bit out, and we say, well, if you wanted a photo, you've got one there, you want a painting, you miss bits out if you don't want them, add bits that you do want, and you can make the flowers a bit bigger or whatever suits you really. Knock trees down if we don't like them, move houses, as artists do all sorts of things like that. Now I think that looks a bit like grass and a few sort of rolling shapes on the cliffs. So we need to start on some flowers next. Rinse my brush well. Now a smaller brush for that, and I'll start with the more distant flowers. So I've got quite a bit of white I'm scooping up, and a bit of this lovely scarlet red. Don't put the exact colour that it is down below. Certainly on my website, I think you can do it on YouTube as well. Still a bit new to all this though. Right, so not sure if you can see that part of the canvas that clearly. Just about you can. I'll start on this here though. don't want to actually try and paint every petal, even when you get to close up, but for there, they would be kind of just pinky white blobs. It's meant to be Thrift. Usually in little groups with a bit of green in between, making the table wobble. A bit bigger there. Got a little bit of green in between them. Carry on with these for now. As they get closer, you can kind of get a little bit more detailed. Just to show you, in case we run out of time. So you could have a little bit more pink. They usually seem to be white on top, I suppose, because that's where the light's hitting them. Remember that they overlap each other, they look much more natural and better if you let them overlap each other a little bit every so often. So we'll make that one, touch that one. A bit more darker pink required there, and a little bit of white on top. So I'm trying to make them a little bit bigger than they would naturally be. I might put some grasses going up over the bank. I think that would look quite nice. If you manage to get a mixture of the pink and the white on your brush, you can kind of dab around and get both colours to appear at the same time. But you do need to go and put a little bit of white at the top though. Unless perhaps you've got into the shadows a bit more. So I'm going to carry on like that. But just because of the time limit with a video, I'll show you how I would put a few dark shapes around to represent leaves and the sort of shadows that you would get naturally. So you have a few darker bits around here. Makes them look a bit more natural and helps to make them stand out a little bit. I'm mixing a bit of Payne's Grey with my greens. Much more detailed information on my website, which is artjanetdavies.co.uk. It's Davies, D-A-V-I-E-S. Davies, as a lot of people say it. And just visiting will help me to tell Google I'm around. Darker bits under those, but not quite as dark as the ones closer to us. And then that's obviously going down and a bit of a dip, so we'll have some darker shapes there. Just go around that flower. And I always do remember the sun's there and just have little bits of sort of a yellowy colour on top of those darker bits, just where the sun's hitting it. So I'll go around like that, filling all that in. Let's just have a hint of grass maybe. Do find a fan brush good for that. And see if this one will do it. Just very light strokes like that. Just a hint that there's some grass there. See if I can't warm up the slightly green there. And what I do quite like to do in my paintings is add a rabbit or a bird. I might do that, we'll see. Let's just get this part of it sort of going first. Some darker bits where the shadows are appearing. And you would see the odd little rock. We should have grass coming part way up and a little bit darker that side. Maybe a little hint of sun. Almost maybe it looked like grass, so a little bit more. It's grey and white. More rocks somewhere along the way. I think that some of this grass is still quite, it's got the sun glowing on it still. Or already it's a sunrise, isn't it? So there we are, we carry on like that with some flowers. Something else I haven't done is put a hint of shadow under there. Bit of finger blending required. Just a hint of a shadow there. And that one for you is just the same. Just about to see that rock into a shadow there. I said a hint brush behaviour, so what I said about a workman blowing these tools. Oh, that's better. Of course I'm a woman, so that doesn't count. Right, so I'll just carry on with some more flowers. And I think that's about done, and I'll put a picture of the finished painting. Thank you very much.